Good morning, everyone. Thank you for joining Olivet's Christmas Day service. Let's begin our opening hymn, Angels We Have Heard on High, Liturgy 978. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward man. O come, let us worship and bow down, let us kneel before the Lord, our Maker. Behold, this is our God, we have waited for him, and he will save us. This is Jehovah, whom we have waited for. Let us be glad and rejoice in his salvation. O Lord Jesus Christ, our Redeemer and Savior, who has declared your love to humans by your birth as the Holy Child in Bethlehem, to whom glory is sung in the highest, while on earth peace is proclaimed, we pray, O Lord, grant your good will toward us and to all people on earth. Cleanse our hearts and make us pure within, that we may worship you in innocence and love, that we may receive you into our hearts and minds. Amen. Our Father, who art in the heavens, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, as in heaven so upon the earth. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we also forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. O turn to me and have mercy on me, because you, Lord, have helped me and comforted me. Please join in saying our recitation today, a passage from the book of Isaiah. Therefore, the Lord himself will give you a sign. Behold, the virgin shall conceive and bear a son, and shall call his name Emmanuel. Let's sing our next hymn, On This Day Earth Shall Ring, Liturgy 950. The word of the Lord as it is written in chapter 1 of the Gospel of Matthew. In this reading, we will hear another, the Lord's nativity. Now, the birth of Jesus Christ was as follows. After his mother Mary was betrothed to Joseph, before they came together, she was found with a child of his Holy Spirit. Then Joseph, her husband, being a just man and not wanting to make her a public example, was minded to put her away secretly. But while he thought about these things, behold, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream, saying, Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take to you Mary, your wife, for that which is conceived in her is of the Holy Spirit, and she will bring forth a son, and you shall call his name Jesus, for he will save his people from their sins. And all this was done that it might be fulfilled, which was spoken by the Lord through the prophet, saying, Behold, the virgin shall be with a child, and bear a son, and they shall call his name Emmanuel, which is translated God with us. Then Joseph, being aroused from sleep, did as the angel of the Lord commanded him, and took to him his wife, and did not know her till she had brought forth her firstborn son, and he called his name Jesus. Our second reading is taken from the work, The True Christian Religion, number 109. All the churches that existed before the Lord coming were representative churches, and only in shadow could the divine truth be seen by them. But after the Lord's coming into the world, a church was established by him, which he saw, or rather was able to see, divine truth in light. The difference is like that between evening and morning. Likewise, in the world, the state of the church before the Lord's coming is called evening, and the state after his coming is called morning. Before the Lord came into the world, he was present with man of the church, but only mediately, through angels who represented him. But since his coming, he is present with men of the church immediately. And this for the reason that in the word he put on also a divine nature, in which he is present with man. The glorification of the Lord is the glorification of his human, which he assumed in the word. And the Lord's glorified human is the divine natural. Amen. Please join us in singing our next hymn, Joy to the World, Liturgy 962. This peaceful morning, this blessed morning, we are exceedingly rejoicing in baby Jesus' birth on earth. We are sure that a multitude of heavenly hosts are joining in praising the Lord's coming and his becoming man on the earth. The Lord wanted to be born our earth. And all this reason behind was that he wanted to be with us. And by being with us, the Lord wanted to save us. That's why the Lord didn't mind taking on our fallen nature and coming to the earth as baby Jesus. And the name of the Lord was foretold in prophet Isaiah, because everything about the Lord's coming and his birth was prepared by the Lord's great providence in his wisdom. And the Lord will be with us, and his name will be called Emmanuel, which is translated God with us. We may think the Lord's presence has been with us all the time. We all know that the first church, the Lord created, the Lord formed Adam out of the dust, and he breathed into his nostrils his life, and then Adam became a living thing, and then he formed the first church on the earth, the most ancient church. And the Lord saved Noah by giving him a warning about the coming flood, and he commanded him to build a huge ark to prepare for the coming flood. And after that, the Lord saved him and his family. And also the Lord blessed them to be multiplied on the earth. And Noah and his people together established the Lord's second church on earth, the ancient church. And the Lord set up, he commanded his servant Moses and sent him to Egypt. And Moses brought out the children of Israel. So by means of Moses and Aaron, the Lord saved and freed the children of Israel from their slavery in the land of Egypt. And the Lord led them into the land of Canaan so that they may establish their kingdom on the land of Canaan, and also the Lord's third church on earth, the Jewish church. So the Lord has been the creator, defender, deliverer, and provider. And in this way, the Lord has been with them, and he is with us. As he said in the book of Revelation, he is the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. And he says that, who is, who was, and who is to come. If the Lord has been with us all the time, what's the glad tidings of a great joy about his birth on earth? What's the big deal about that? Because he is with us. He will be with us all the time. The reason why we are rejoicing, we become very glad about his birth on earth, is that the Lord took on divine natural degree, which did not exist before. And also, by taking on his natural degree, just like us, the Lord could be with us immediately, and which didn't exist before, because the Lord did not have his natural degree. And another important reason for our rejoice is because the Lord didn't mind taking all this and preparing all this to save us. That's why we are exceedingly rejoicing in this glad tidings. Obviously, a few churches existed before the Lord's coming, but those churches could worship the Lord very remotely because the Lord did not have his natural degree. The Lord could talk to them. The Lord could convey his message by means of angels. So the Lord actually seemed like he really appeared before many great people. But the Lord employed angels to do that job. The Lord filled with the divine in angels, and angels thought they were divine, and they acted like the Lord, and they brought the message of the Lord to the people. So the Lord did not have this physical body. So when he needed to show up, the Lord had to employ angels. That's why Arcana Celestia 1590 teaches us that the three heavens are the image of the external man of the Lord. So all angels served that specific use. And in many places in prophets, there's a distinction between the churches before coming and after coming. The churches before is like a state in nighttime because the Lord was not present directly, immediately. They worshiping the Lord in shadow, in a representative way. That's why they had to use many symbols and many representations, because the Lord could not be reached directly, could not be worshipped immediately. By means of those mediums, the Lord could be worshipped. But after his coming, people actually could see the Lord, could hear the teachings from his mouth. They could eat together with the Lord. How wonderful. They have waited for his coming, and they have worshiped the Lord by means all kinds of mediate ways. Now they could see the Lord. They could hear the truth from the mouth of the Lord. That's why the church, after his coming, is compared to morning state. And the Lord didn't mind to become man like us, so that he could be near to us, and he could do all his works more effectively by having his natural degree. And also, the prophecy is given in Isaiah, a virgin shall conceive and bear a child, and his name will be called Emmanuel, which means God with us. Actually, this passage, this prophecy was given to King Ahaz, king of Judah, because he was in a great stress at the time. At the time, king of Israel and king of Syria wanted to revolt against Assyria. And they forced the king of Judah, Ahaz, to join them in a coalition against the king of Assyria. And to make that happen, king of Syria and king of Israel, they threatened Ahaz, and they threatened to attack Jerusalem. So the Lord wanted to give him some assurance. And the Lord gave this passage by means of his prophet Isaiah, a child will be born. In a deeper meaning, this whole thing which makes sense. Because here, Jerusalem represents the Lord's church and also his teachings from the Word. And the Lord wanted to defend Jerusalem, which means the Lord wanted to defend and protect his church and his word. So anything threatened the existence and the soundness and the safety of his church and his word, the Lord wanted to come to defend and to protect his word. So the Lord was pleased to be born on earth. The time was right, which means when his church was threatened and the status of his word was also under attack. Because at the time, there was no any truth available in the church. Without any truth, any goodness could come out of it. So the Lord had to come to defend his church and his word. And as he promised, as foretold, the Lord came to the earth as baby Jesus. And his name will be called Emmanuel, God with us. When the Lord was on earth, he made himself available to all people, to all kinds of people. And the Lord gave them very clear assurance that he will protect them. He will lead them into eternal happiness, which is the Lord's heavenly kingdom. And also the Lord taught them from his mouth. And the people haven't seen that such authority, such wisdom before. So the Lord, by his coming, he could bring all the people to himself. And also, he had a chance to teach how to live, how to believe in the Lord, and how to worship him, how to love the Lord and the neighbors. His name was foretold to be Emmanuel, God with us, because the Lord wanted to be born, and the most important reason was to restore his holiness of the world to its original place. And the most essential teaching in his word is that he became human. He became the man. Why is it so important to believe that the Lord actually came to us and he became a human, a person like us, so that people could have any sensual ideas and images about the Lord? We may understand something by very rational, intellectual concepts and ideas, but when we have sensual experiences, this conceptual ideas and the concepts can be very powerful. Just think about when we came back to worship at the sanctuary after one and a half years later, and many members here had tears, and it was so moving to be present in the actual building, sitting on the pews. Though it has been only 1.5 years, we became so emotional. We was delighted. It was very joyful and moving. But think about those people who worship the Lord and who have been waiting for his coming. And when actually was born and the Lord was with them, they could be with the Lord. Their joy and delight was indescribable, beyond the words. And also the Lord wanted to show him to other people so that people could have clear and concrete ideas about the Lord and about Jesus Christ. And by this way, they could understand, they could reach out to the concept of infinite God, Heavenly Father. So that's why the Lord wanted to be born on the earth And the Lord wanted to be showing all those his images clearly. And the Lord wanted to keep that in his word, so that all the teachings in the word, and including the fact that he became a man, could be preserved throughout generations by preserving his word. To make all this happen, the Lord had to be born, and he wanted to be called Emmanuel, God with us. In this natal day of the Lord, we are exceedingly rejoicing in his birth, because his coming is for the sake of our salvation. And we are very grateful for what he has done for us. And the Lord wants to be with us, as his name clearly proclaimed that. But interestingly, this Hebrew word, his name, Emmanuel, especially a preposition im in Hebrew, means several things. Obviously, the principal meaning is with, but it also has some other meanings like by, beside, accompanying, and among, and even against. So these various meanings seems represent the relationship we are in with the Lord. Though the Lord want to be directly with us, perhaps he is still beside us. Perhaps he's standing by us, still locking the door of our minds to enter into us, to dine with us. The Lord can be with us, among us, but it sounds like the Lord can be with us only collectively, but maybe not yet individually. We can come to church, we can join in worship services. In this way, the Lord could be collectively with us. But how much he is individually with us? Even sometimes we fight with the Lord. Sometimes we wrestle with the Lord. Sometimes we argue with his truth, his clear providence. We are against him. In what way we are with the Lord? Is he beside us? Is he by us? Or even we are against him? The Lord came down to be with us because it is the best way to save us. He should be with us so that he can bring all those blessings he mentioned, and he could perform all those wonderful, powerful miracles he showed them while he was on earth. The Lord should be with us. Behold, I am with you always, even to the end of age. Amen. Please join us in singing our next hymn, O Come, Emmanuel, Liturgy 968. Thank you. us pray. O Lord Emmanuel, God with us, our Savior Jesus Christ, we give thanks to you with joyfulness of heart. You have fulfilled the promises of your ancient prophets and have in the flesh come into the world. Grant that in the wilderness of this earthly life, our hearts may hear the voice of your word, preaching to us repentance for the remission of our sins. May your will be done in our hearts as it is done in heaven. Help us to open you the door of your hearts, that you may come in and dine with us. And you are with us. O Lord, lead us by your truth and teach us, that you may be with us always, even forevermore. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you all. Amen. Let us sing our closing hymn, Come on the Listening Ear of Night, Liturgy 966.